If you guys like this review, be sure to support my work on Patreon. The Little Mermaid was Disney's 29th animated feature film and was based on a famous fairy tale by Hans Christian Andersen. The film was released in theaters on November 17, 1989 to largely positive reviews, garnering over $84 million at the box office during its initial release. Yes, I will clarify that Who Framed Roger Rabbit should be given credit for bringing life back to the art of Disney animated feature films, but The Little Mermaid was the one that marked the start of an era known as the Disney Renaissance. This film was grossed over $211 million worldwide. Now, why was this movie so great? Well, let's talk about the plot. The story begins with Ariel, the underwater princess who wants to see what the land above has to offer, but her father King Triton forbids against this and has a distaste for humanity. Later, Ariel meets the prince Eric and falls in love with him and saves him from the storm. She makes a deal with the infamous Ursula the Sea Witch and trades her voice for legs and tries to gain Eric's affection, and Ursula's evil plans were set in motion. Then Ursula gets defeated and Ariel and Eric get married, and that's basically the plot. And honestly, I would say this film was the company saving grace, because after their previous films that were either blockbuster bombs or lost to previous films. And I would say that this film brought Disney its reputation and saved the company from its dark age. And I can see why this film was a major hit. The animations, the songs, even though the plot is a little bit sketchy at first, but it is still a greatest film. To its peak. I mean, Disney did something that would give its reputation back in animation industry at the time. Since at that same year, Don Bluth, who has been Disney over the years with his works like The Secret of Nim and his recent successful film The American Tale, and he recently released his film at the same year known as All Dogs Go to Heaven, which Disney finally beat that film for the first time in years. And The Little Mermaid had received both the Academy Awards and Golden Globes for Best Song and Best Score. Now let's talk about the animation of this film. It is truly beautiful, and the style of the environment of the ocean and the under the sea are truly remarkable, and the tone with colors in the reefs, the rocks, even the bubble effects are truly breathtaking that will make you admire the sea and its beauty. And the color patterns in each sea creatures is flawlessly executed so well that it makes you feel like you're literally in the world below the water. And I will admit, the scenery above land is amazing as well. And here's a fun fact, did you know that Ariel's look was based on a young model named Sherry Stoner? If it wasn't for her, we would not have this amazing mermaid character we all know and love today. And not to mention Jodie Benson being the voice actress who brought Ariel's voice to life. And I will admit, Ariel in the film was portrayed as a rebellious and adventurous character. And to this very day, everyone can relate to her in many ways. How would Ashman and Ellen make it being the greatest duet of musical artwork at their time, made and composed the songs and scores for this film? And here is a Disney fact that you all pretty much know at this point. Jeffrey Katzenberg almost cut the very well-known song Part of Your World from the film, but Howard Ashman persuaded Jeff to let him be in charge of the song, and Howard actually worked with Jodie Benson and made her put emotion and feel into the song. And thanks to Howard Ashman, the song stayed. And I thank Howard Ashman for saving the film from Jeff's mistake. In my opinion, is one of the iconic songs of the movie. If you disagree with my statement that Howard Ashman would save Part of Your World from Jeffrey's mistake, feel free to explain that in the comment sections below this video. And not to mention, the score that Ellen Menken have composed for this film as well totally makes this film feel alive to the audience, and it's good to listen to. And Howard Ashman made songs that could be stuck on your head no matter how many times you hear it and want to sing along to it. However, despite the great animation, great songs, and most likely great characters in the story, but the plot, as I stated very earlier, it seemed a bit rushed. We barely get to see the chemistry between Ariel and Eric during the 3-day period. And honestly, I think the film should have focused on these two having a chemistry that cut enough to the side characters while Eric and Ariel were going on the tour of the kingdom at that time. Now, I get that the film teaches the younger audience that the moral is to strive for your goals without compromising who you are, but I feel that they need to make more scenes and to give it more depth to make the moral stay true and actually feel accurate. But all in all, this film is still wonderful in my book. The animation is perfect, the characters are funny and perfect, and frankly, this film is adored by kids and adults these past 29 years, and I hope it keeps entertaining audiences for years to come. I am Ben Maza, may the force be with you all, and have a good day. Thank you.